Martin Luther King Jr. was arguably the most influential man in recent history. Making the pipe dreams of many African Americans of the 1960s a reality through years of determination for injustice against black Americans that was a daily occurrence throughout the US. He was backed in his life for the struggle for equality by people like Rosa Parks, white and black university students, and even President Kennedy himself. Martin Luther King was born on January 15th, 1929. His legal name at birth was Michael King, also his father's name at the time.
I'm going to give the best life to our son, Alberta.
Is this going to hurt?
Yes, lots. Over my...
Oh!
I will leave you.
There's your son, Alberta. What do you want to call him?
No, I see that.
Oh, you don't have to include him. Let's call him MLK Jr. after me. I'll make sure he's a damn good Christian.
At the age of 13, King denied the bodily resurrection of Jesus during Sunday school. From this point, he stated, doubts began to spring forth unrelentingly. However, he later concluded that the Bible has many profound truths of which one cannot escape and decided to enter the seminary. He then went on to have his own church. Today, people go in there in memory of Dr. King, including President Obama himself.
Scripture tells us that when Joshua and the Israelites arrived at the gates of Jericho, they could not enter. The walls of the city were too steep for any one person to climb. They were too strong to be taken down by brute force. And so the people sat for days, unable to pass on through. But God had a plan for his people. He told them to stand together and march together around the city. And on the seventh day, he told them that when they heard the sound of the ram's horn, they should speak with one voice. And at the chosen hour, when the horn sounded, and a chorus of voices cried out together, the mighty walls of Jericho came tumbling down.
Even though Martin Luther King Sr. wanted his son to have a good life, he wasn't afraid to beat him when he thought it was necessary.
Come here, you swine!
Dad, don't please.
No!
No, 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 no! Dad?
Yeah?
Can I go to an interview in college?
You ain't going nowhere in the great college, son.
Why?
So I don't want you to mix with no white people, son. They hate us.
Even though this argument took place, Martin Luther King disobeyed his father and went to an integrated college. During college, he got himself a girlfriend named Betty. The couple got on well. When they realized they could not marry because of segregation, the couple split. This left Martin Luther King angry and heartbroken.
You know I love you so much. But would my dad not want us to be together because of the fact you're white? And the recent KKK lynchings of I love you too. But I just can't love you anymore. Goodbye, Betty.
In 1955, a young black girl known as Linda Brown went to her local court to appeal the decision not to allow her into an all-white school by their Board of Education. After many trials and going through her local, state, and finally Supreme Court, she was finally granted the right to attend this school. This was a major breakthrough in the discrimination in education for black people.
There just ain't any reason why I can't go to that school. Except I'm black, and that just ain't right,
you know what? I think you're right, Miss Brown. This brings up some very important arguments on the desegregation of schools.
Objection!
Overruled! Now, what does the jury think?
We rule in favour of Miss Brown, Your Honour.
Very well, Linda Brown will be allowed to attend the all-white school, and the Southern Skates will desegregate their schools with all deliberate speed.
On December 1st, 1955, Rosa Parks was arrested for refusing to give up her seats.
Thanks very much.
Move, woman. I need to sit down.
No, I've had a long day.
Move.
No.
Driver, this Negro is refusing to move.
Can you move, please?
No.
I'll have to call the police. Well... someone will get off the bus, sir.
Okay, I'll arrest them. Please move off the bus.
No!
Take them to the station.
No!
Rosa Parks' action sparked one of the first examples of successful peaceful protest, leading to the desegregation of buses in Montgomery due to the efforts of the MIA.
For a number of years, the Negro passengers on the city bus lines of Montgomery have been humiliated, intimidated, and faced threats on this bus line. Just the other day, one of the fine citizens of our community, Mrs. Rosa Parks, was arrested because she refused to give up her seat for a white passenger. Mrs. Rosa Parks was arrested and taken down to jail, taken from the bus, just because she refused to give up her seat. At present, we are in the midst of a protest, the Negro citizens of Montgomery, representing some 44% of the population. 90% at least of the regular Negro bus passengers are staying off the buses, and we plan to continue until something is done.
The MIA came into being that very afternoon, and MLK Jr. accepted the presidency. As MIA leader, King became the focus of white hatred. On January 30th, 1956, the King home was bombed.
Why are we alone in time at our home?
A non-violent approach. If we use violence, then we are no better than they. The whites, go home.
Oh.
Bye, boys.
The boycott, December 20, 1956. After 381 days, the city passed an ordinance authorizing black bus passengers to sit virtually anywhere they choose on the buses. The Montgomery bus boycott resounded far beyond the desegregation of public buses. It stimulated activism and participation from the South in national civil rights movements and gave King national attention as a rising leader.
I, Martin Luther King Jr., stand here today at the scene of the first unsegregated bus in the United States of America. Not because of my heroic acts, I stand before you today celebrating and basking in the success of all my brothers and sisters that stood up against discrimination for all of us. We now have our own simple birthright. The courage and moral determination showed by all the people involved, coloured or not, that started something that will have changed our lives and our children's lives for good. Rosa Parks Saturday and the whole community finished it, and together we have shown that us black people are going to fight for our rights.
On September 20th, 1958, Isola Ware Curry, a 42-year-old mentally disturbed woman, stabbed Martin Luther King Jr. while he signed copies of his book, Stride Toward Freedom, at Bloomstein's department store in Harlem, New York. Curry approached King with a 7-inch steel letter opener and drove the blade into the upper left of his chest.
You're under arrest.
King was released from hospital without any severe injuries. This was a shock for Dr. King. It was another wake-up call, even after the bombing of the King's residence. On the 2nd of May, 1963, students from Birmingham, Alabama, a town notorious for its particularly brutal treatment of black people, more than 1,000 students skipped class to join a march to downtown Birmingham. This march was organized by the SCLC to make all of America see the hatred towards black people that was still strong in the Deep South at the time. And this was organized and led by Dr. King himself. Day 2 of the march, when hundreds more students gathered to march for another protest, the commissioner, Paul Connor himself, ordered the police force and fire department to use high-pressure hoses. This protest, along with the boycotts, meant to pressure business leaders to open employment to public facilities, restaurants and stores, was probably one of the many important successful events that made American black and white see the extreme racism in the Deep South, and an amazing example of direct protest as it effectively shut down the city and drew attention to racial problems through the media.
I have a dream.
The March on Washington for Jobs and Freedom, or the Great March on Washington, as styled in a sound recording released after the event, was one of the largest political rallies for human rights in United States history and called for civil and economic rights for African Americans. It took place in Washington, D.C. Thousands of Americans headed to Washington on Tuesday, August 27th, 1963. On Wednesday, August 28th, 1963, Dr. King, standing in front of the Lincoln Memorial, delivered his historic I Have a Dream speech, in which he called for an end to racism. The march was organized by a group of civil rights, labor, and religious organizations under the theme Jobs and Freedom. Estimates of the number of participants varied from 200,000 to 300,000. Observer estimated that 75 to 80% of the marchers were black.
I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. Yeah.
A shot rang out as King stood on the motel's second floor balcony. The bullet entered through his right cheek, smashing his jaw, then traveled down his spinal cord before lodging in his shoulder.
Martin! Martin! Are you okay, Martin? You're gonna be a promise. Just don't lick to the light. Martin, we need some help.
Don't wanna close.
If I should die this very moment, I wouldn't fear, for I've never known completeness like being here, wrapped in the warmth of you, loving every breath of you.
Join us in this priceless personality class to see all the bloopers and mistakes we all very frequently made.
Feel with all the strength I find, there's nothing I can't do.
You know I love you so much. But would my dad not wanting us to be together because of the fact you're white? The KKK lynching, black mixed with white relationships, we can't be through.
I love you too.
What?
I just can't love you anymore.
Goodbye, Betty.
They're very enthusiastic, they're actually a good bunch of people, like, they all get along with each other.
Well, David thinks it's more like a reality show than anything else.
Not saying nothing.
You're a dead end and a waste of conversation.
I get on with everyone, pretty much.
Could you be any more less emotional?
Is that just everyone tolerates you, or just? I would like to think everyone is more than tolerable.
Beautiful words for a handsome young man. Glorious!
It's cracking! It's cracking!
He's quite angry. He's strangling people.
Yeah, it's quite scary.
He's a bit terrifying.
He goes like that to people.
Great impressions there, ladies. Well done.
Patrick, as the enforcer, what do you think about that highly emotional scene?
Strangling people!
All we have, arrows, because I don't want to miss a thing when this happens.
I can do it over the top.
Yeah,
Aerosmith,
don't
want to
miss
the thing. The
project the missus set up for us is a good idea.
No, it's so bad. It's so bad.
Yes.
Jesse Jackson.
Tom, you're a man.
Jesse Jackson is not on that.
Yeah.
Jesse is a man's name.
Jesse.
One.
Oh, we're at that time.
Oh. What's it? Oh. I'm used to being a woman.
You ready?
Do you
like this?
I think it's going to be quite fun, and there are going to be hilarious results with when we get the final cut.
Come on.
a long way, but we're not too sure where we've been. We've had success, we've had good times, but remember this. Being on this path of life for so long, feel I've walked 1,000 miles. Sometimes stroll hand in hand with love. Everybody's been there. With danger on my mind, I would stand on the line.
Deeps. There you go. Let me take a selfie. I've ruined it. On second, that's not even worded correctly. God damn it.
My face in the moon.
Yeah, I bet you can hear me. It doesn't matter, that face. You want to hear my sweet tune in these bloopers? You can hear it. You can hear it.
Have to see me.
When the children's. Oh, God, you. I'm not reading March 4 times in a row.
Yet each day seems to make much more.
What if your legs didn't know they were legs?
Understand the meaning of a feeling now. That it feels so unreal. And I see the hand
particularly
that
particularly. Streets back, all right.